confusion will be my epitaph.
Scary monsters.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, it's your boy here. I hope you are all having a good day, because it's about to be ruined. I should mention before anything else that I have a pretty bad cough right now, so if I see any comments joking about you know what, you're going on the fucking list, okay? You're not funny. Right, so we're gonna be taking a look at the Maps IRL podcast. Now, if you don't know what a map is, then I suggest that you just leave right now, because you're honestly better off not knowing. They currently have 13 episodes up on their YouTube channel, and I took the courtesy of sitting through eight of them. Without a single drop of alcohol. Mind you. You people better appreciate my sacrifice. We are going to respond to a few clips taken from various episodes where our lovely hosts discuss a few topics. I'm doing my absolute best not to take any of this out of context, but to be honest with you, this podcast is really, really boring to listen to, so I will mostly be playing the juicy bits. With the composition out of the way, let's jump right into our first topic.
It's okay.
It's not utopian though, dude. Every other minority group gets it. Like, literally everybody else got their club. We are not allowed to have a club.
We've seen it in the LGBTQ population where it's like, this one queer person was like, I don't like that gay marriage is allowed, because, like, real talk, now everyone's assuming.
Like, it would be funny if there weren't so many negative connotations with mapness. Like, it'd be like, mm-hmm. like coming out as gay and someone not asking you any questions, like, what's your type or something like that. Like, that's fine.
Here's something these guys do all the time. They keep comparing themselves to da gays and da queers. They call their lust for little boys a sexuality and their community a minority group. It's honestly kind of creepy how they keep falling back to the LGBT community with almost every topic.
So do you think that maps need pride?
No.
Literally, why are we not allowed to have pride when we, like, are human beings with functioning brains and you're the people telling us that our brains aren't functioning right when we can be fucking normal and we can have fun and we're allowed to do everything you normie motherfuckers can do? I mean, we're still not there with other minorities. We're just joining in the pack.
No, you're not. I think the reason they're so dead set on getting a spot in Pride is because they just assume that the LGBTQ plus community will accept any form of degeneracy as long as you sugarcoat it and slap a sticker on it that says sexuality.
And I mean, if we're gonna go into the history of it, like, there were maps at Stonewall, and mapness has been a huge part of the LGBTQ community for so fucking long.
Look. I don't know all that much about the history and the lore of the LGBTQ plus community because, you know, big scary straight white man, but its members seem to be quite vocal about not wanting anything to do with maps. From what I've seen, you guys just have a long history of trying to force your way into Pride. I mean, come on guys, like, even the anonymous Vorsexual wants you to fuck off.
Love each other. He's 82 years old. And he's a map, which is so cool, because I'm like, you are, like, such a good role model for maps, because, like, you're, like, this never offended, like, sees romance in relationships like this, is a father, is a husband, it's still, like, his wife has passed, but, like, before that, like, loved his wife, no matter what his sexuality was.
Now I find this topic to be the most important in this already very weak argument. Pedophilia is not a sexuality. It is a fetish. What I'm going to say next is entirely hypothetical, but say you have a map that is asexual, like one of the guys in this podcast claims to be, and they are only romantically interested in children, then it's technically no longer a fetish, I guess, but still not a sexuality, and I'll tell you why right now. This is where I see a fundamental difference between homosexuality and pedophilia. Even if a child had the brain capacity to engage in a romantic relationship with an adult, said adult is only in love with the age of that child. At least, if you're like a normal homosexual person, you will love your partner for who they are, and not just one aspect of their personality, that being age, which is also temporary. Now, let's just very quickly drop the hypothetical idea that this child understands the intricacies of a romantic and or sexual relationship, because that is biologically impossible at such a young age. A child will only love you in the same way it loves a friend or even a parent. The guys in this podcast claim to understand and respect this, but I will get back to that later. My point here still stands. If a child loves you and trusts you, and you take advantage of that trust, even if it's not in a sexual way, that could ruin that kid forever.
Well, because I feel like they've been trying to find the reason people are gay and the reason people are trans and the reason that people are anything, including maps, for literally like since the 60s. And I don't think we've ever found a definite plan. So maybe I'm being super like aggressive about this, sorry, but I don't think it's happening.
These pedo experts are saying their arguments, they agree with longstanding stereotypes about us. And they try to give a simple answer to a complex concept, and then so, like, the conversation is over.
There was no conversation to begin with. Mapness, as you like to call it, has a multitude of causes, I think, because I assume it just works the same way as any other fetish, in that it usually stems from some childhood experiences.
But scientists speak for us. We apparently don't know our own feelings, and only scientists can explain how we feel.
Scientists speak for you because you either don't understand why those feelings are bad, or you are just playing dumb.
If we start getting scientific backing from people, is that going to push us even further into a divisive society? I mean, it happened with LGBTQ people. It's going to happen with us. No ifs, ands, or buts about it.
It's not going to happen to you. Because any competent scientist can point out that having a bunch of neckbeards frolicking around proudly with a stupid pedo rainbow flag is a recipe for disaster. Not only that, but what defines scientific backing? Nobody is gonna find the key to justifying wanting to grope toddlers by hooking your neocortex up to some wires. Even if you had scientific backing, the slight improvement in reputation you will get will be negligible. People aren't just dumb, pinheaded robots that will completely turn their moral compass around just because, like, National Geographic publishes an article talking about how maps are actually wonderful people. It's just not gonna happen.
We blared, like, I Love Little But Girls by Oingo Boingo.
Fuck off. I like Oingo Boingo. Don't ruin good music for me.
Jesus fucking Christ, man, these people fucking whip my brain. Oh god, I think I gotta close my eyes for a second. I just gotta lay down for a second.
Hello, as of now, due to him having to sit through the majority of this podcast, he's currently suffering from
brain damage.
So for now, I'll cover this segment for him until he recovers. Now, before I begin talking about this, I just want to briefly cover over why general pedophilia can be such an issue, both for victims and for those with the mental disorder, since not many people seem to discuss it whenever they cover the topic of pedophilia. For those with a mental disorder, it can be very, and I mean very intrusive. It would cause the person to have urges they want absolutely nothing to do with. This can be a massive issue for those who just want to live a normal life because it can actually make things more difficult for them. But those are the ones who know it's wrong and abnormal and are trying their hardest to control said urges through any means possible, like for example therapy if they're lucky enough, in order to cause no harm. But a vast majority of those pedophiles are putting in all the effort to try to normalize the mental disorder and try labeling it as a sexual orientation instead. Some of the people within that majority would actually give in to their urges, and this is where the issues for the victims come through. Keep in mind the demographic of most victims in these cases. Minors, or in other words, anybody who is under the legal age of adulthood, usually 18. In most cases, it is painted that minors can't consent because they don't have the mental capacity to consider the weight or the consequences of doing things like this. Some of them might not even understand the mere concept of these things, and if a pedophile ever acts upon their urges, whether it be online or in real life, it can traumatize a victim and will always come back to haunt them no matter what they try to do. This is especially true when it comes to stuff online because of how quickly child pornography can spread throughout the internet. Those kinds of pedophiles who act upon their urges prey on children's innocence and will do anything to hold their dominance over them. Even if they were a quote-unquote no-map, which stands for a non-offending minor attracted person, some twisted minds can actually use this to their advantage when they try to normalize this sort of thing. If they were talking about how it's all fine and dandy to have fantasies about knocking up children, and a minor caught wind of that, this can actually make a bad influence on the child, making them think that things like this are perfectly fine and blurs a line in their morality. Yes, a lot of these stories online actually prove this point true, and no, sadly, there is nothing much we could do about it. Oh boy. That, my fellow comrades, should already be enough to keep your ear holes wide open when this subject somehow pops up in normal conversation. Which I honestly hope it doesn't pop up too often. Okay, now enough about that, I kinda sidetracked. Back to what I actually wanted to cover. Now within this episode of this podcast, we're introduced to a new character, Lo. A map, or minor attracted person, who also happens to be a mother for a son at a very young age. As we have established as of now, the terms minor attractive person and parent is just calling for disaster. The reason I brought up the previous segment where I explained why this predatory behavior or thought process is such an issue is because it can actually contradict a lot of the things brought up in the episode of the podcast. For example, lovely quotes like this,
but, and I was worried that, you know, like, just by being a map in his presence, you know how some aunties will be like, oh, kids can tell. And oh, yeah. Made uncomfortable by you just by being in your radius, which is stupid and wrong, but you know.
And this.
So I was worried that, you know, I was like, oh, just by being a map at all, am I gonna inherently fuck up my kid just by existing? And I got really depressed about it, but.
I know, let's not forget about this.
Once that passed, and it became very clear very quickly that whole, like, anti-concept of maps can't be parents because you're just an animal ready to jump on literally anyone who's under the age of 18. Not the case at all.
Is immediately shot down when I mention the fact that there is a reason stranger danger is a thing. Lord knows what many people can do to children who are gullible enough to accept a request from someone who could potentially traumatize them and strip them of their innocence. This is all a better safe than sorry route we all tend to take, because we'd much rather not take a risk with someone who can become a potential predator. We legitimately care for our youth, for the most part, not counting the few idiots who claim to do something when they don't, and we don't want someone who will at some point decide they would want to grapple onto children. Our worries increase even more when a map is a parent, considering the possibility that the parent might get abusive, whether mentally, through manipulation, like I previously mentioned, or sexually, because yes, a lot of the parents turned out to be very sexually abusive towards their children, and we're praying in every cent of our being that we can do something to keep that child away from that map's custody to prevent such a thing. And while it may not be an issue now, as Lo may have painted, it can become a massive issue later down the line, and it can occur in multiple ways. And just thinking about the amount of ways this could occur is making me feel sick to my damn stomach. Oh, also, off topic, I find it very hilarious that the people in this podcast are complaining about why they're outcast to so many people when the reason is actually clear as day. Many people, understandably, don't want to associate with those kinds of people because, again, the better safe than sorry scenario, just in case someone like them ever decides to give in to their twisted fantasies. The only good thing I ever saw in that episode is when she mentioned that she told her son that it was a mental disorder, which is actually true. There is literal scientific proof to back this up. But even then, when she said that, it felt a little skewed because she did hint at some point she wishes to discuss it as if it's a sexual orientation as well. As HP covered in previous parts, it's only attraction to the age. It's not necessarily sexuality, per se. What happens when that love interest turns 18? Or is it just to get a little illegal kick out of it?
The stereotype of us being manipulative is the funniest thing in the entire world for me, because no offense to any maps listening who this falls to, most maps I know are so anxious, they stumble over their, like, themselves on a daily basis.
No, of course not. Of course maps aren't manipulative. No, it's totally not manipulative at all to go the same route as incels and start using your own little vocabulary to describe things. You know just as well as I do that the only reason you call yourselves maps is so that you can avoid outright calling yourselves pedophiles, even though that's exactly what you are. Most normal people have never heard of the term map, so it's an excellent way for you guys to sugarcoat everything when explaining it to people. Bleh. I would like to think those conversations go a little something like this.
Well, hello there, neighbor! How are you doing this fine morning?
I'm a fucking map, mate!
What?
A map is an old minor attractive person.
That's quite interesting. So that means that you're attracted to only slightly to people in like a sexual way or something?
No, it means I'm attracted to minors.
Wait, you don't mean to say...
I'm a fucking noose man!
What about calling normal people teleophiles? That makes it sound like you're talking about just another group or community, while in reality it just means pretty much anyone that's not a sig degenerate.
Because I definitely know I've changed more minds when people DM me and I sit down and actually have a conversation with them and like talk to them and like become friends with them.
Yes, we're friends now, aren't we? No, see, I'm not that bad. Pedophiles can be your friends too, little Jimmy. You enjoying that lowly pop I bought you?
Prevention Project Dunkelfeld, which is like a program in Germany to help maps who are afraid to break laws. But it's like a very prejudiced project. Like it's practically sees a lot of maps as potentially criminal instead of actually human beings, and
it's not prejudice at all, because technically you are a potential threat to society. Even if you claim you would never touch a kid, there's no guarantee that you won't ever slip up, or if you're just lying about that, it's not prejudice at all that people are concerned about you guys openly parading the fact that you're craving little boys.
I want to get to the point where people, they respect pedophiles, they don't just respect pedo experts, and they don't just respect people as individuals as maps, but rather respect the attraction in general.
Alright, here's my most controversial stance here, but yeah, here we go. I think it's safe to say that, like, some pedophiles are respectable individuals. Hear me out on this, please. It must be absolute hell to have those urges that you can't control. So to any pedophiles out there that are keeping that shit to themselves, that are privately seeking help, repressing those feelings because they know it's wrong, I seriously do have a lot of respect for those people. However, I cannot respect maps, because even if you tell me that you know it's wrong to touch children, and you tell me you would never do that, it proves to me that you don't understand the bigger picture. You shouldn't even be open about that shit, because it doesn't help anyone. If you really know it's wrong to have those urges, then you should understand that pedo exception is useless. Let's say it becomes acceptable to openly talk about your pedophilia. What good will that do to you? Say you can go out drinking with your map friends and you keep egging each other on, you start catcalling some kids maybe, you know, daring each other, eventually things escalate and you end up doing something you will regret for the rest of your life. And you're gonna ruin a child's life on top of that too. Accepting pedophilic urges is step one. Step two is accepting getting frisky with little Jimmy down the street. It will never happen. It should never happen. Ah, I need more water. Let me trail off for a second here. Whenever I record, I become like Foo Fighters from JoJo because I need to drink water every 2 seconds because my mouth dries out and then my lips begin to smack and it's fucking disgusting. Jesus. We've reached the end of the line, everyone. If you're still on the train, thank you so much for sticking around and getting through this bullshit together. This last part is gonna be about a few gems I found while listening to the podcast that don't belong in any fixed category, but are nonetheless very interesting to talk about.
This year, actually, I decided to come out to my entire school. I got doxxed over the summer, people were trying to get me kicked out of school. It has been a wild time.
I wonder why. Imagine being this oblivious to the rules of society.
And I hear this one woman say, like, oh my god, like, do you hear what they're talking about? It's a bunch of freaks, like, what's going on in there? Like, what is wrong with those people? They're wearing it on their shirts.
Yes, imagine going to a cafe with the grandma gang and seeing a bunch of fat pigs with lolly hentai shirts covered in cum and grease, drooling over the 2-year-old kid covering his face in spaghetti in the corner of the room. It is kind of a beautiful sight to behold. It's so perfect, to be honest. I would pay money to see that.
I don't know. I feel like the more you explain to teleophiles sometimes, the more creeped out or disgusted they get, and it's real frustrating. Because I'm like, no, I'm trying to be open with you, and you're just recoiling, like...
It's like I've said earlier, if someone's never heard the term map before, and then you as a map try to sugarcoat it to them, the only thing that will really achieve is that they will only gradually get more and more repulsed by you the more they start to see through your bullshit. Why can't you have some mercy and just tell them outright that you're a pedophile? Why does the execution of your argument have to be so slow and painful while you could just make it so much easier on yourself?
A girl who doesn't like me but hasn't liked me since I came out, we used to be pretty good friends. At a point, I turn over and she's crying and is screaming and I'm like, what is going on? And they're like, their one friend comes over, says I should leave. And it's just like,
she's a total bitch for crying. Like, seriously, imagine like being such a kind and considerate person that being in a room with a potential child predator hurts you emotionally. That's my impression of this guy. Please tell me in the comments if it's any good or not, because I want to get into voice acting.
I mean, when you attack maps or gay people, like, and like, you need to, like, be so hateful of them, then that's probably a sign that you're not comfortable with your own sexuality, and...
That is only true when you apply it to homophobic people. In the case of maps, it's... Fuck! In the case of maps, it's because it's on a scientific basis immoral to be a nonce. Like, I'm pretty confident in my sexuality. I'm not uncomfortable around trans or gay people, but that doesn't say much anyway, because once again, the comparison between the gays and the nonces is null.
We are in Pride, and we are being prideful, and we are saying exactly the things that are on our mind. And so what if it offends some fucking teleos? Like, dude, like... We are not conspiring to harm anybody.
Okay, if I give you the benefit of the doubt and say, like, you might not be out to harm people, but you sure as heck might cause others to do so with your podcast. Being a map and open about it is dangerous beyond an individual level. Alright, I can't believe I'm still alive. Like, how about you, my dear troops? How many soldiers have we lost along the way, and how battle-scarred are you? Let me know in the comments down below, and if you enjoyed our little dive into the internet cesspit, please consider subscribing. I'll see you in the next one, but in the meantime, please go tend to each other's wounds, be kind to one another, and beware of the scary monsters that lurk below.